Hello? Is anyone there? Hello? Anyone? Oh, hey everyone. I'm so happy that you guys made it here. You're probably wondering, where are we? Well, last Friday, my sister Annalie and I were hiking up Mount Parklantis when we were about to give up, but then we remembered to have, wait, what's that word again? Grit, that's right. Refusing to give up even when life gets hard. And man, let me tell you, that climb was really hard. I almost broke a nail. But anyways, I'm here. While we were searching, hiking up Mount Parklantis, we found the jungle of Jehovah. That's right, I'm here searching for the tree of truth. But the only problem is, I'm really scared. Like, what will happen to my dog, May? Who's gonna play fetch with her? She probably will get really lonely. Wait, what about my Minecraft character? I was almost on level 80. What about my friends and my family back home? They're probably gonna miss me. Wait, friends, family, Annalie? What was that? Annalie, is that you? Annalie, thank goodness, I was so scared.
Anyways, being all alone is pretty scary, and it's one of my biggest fears. What are some of your biggest fears?
Being super.
Like, when I be scared of jungles alone.
Okay. You're being scared of jungles and alone?
When I'm alone in the dark.
Well, that's pretty scary. That's the worst.
I'm afraid of Dane.
Bro, and I'm afraid of Noah.
Oh. What are you afraid of?
I'm afraid of being in a small room that is dark, because I don't like the dark at
That is a really specific scary thing.
Clowns.
Oh, creepy clowns.
You.
What?
Spiders and being in Harry Potter.
Being in Harry Potter? That's oddly specific.
Spiders.
Spiders. We got two spiders.
Death.
Death, it makes sense. And last one, right here.
In the dark in the hallway upstairs.
Oh, that is, those are some pretty big fears. But thankfully, our word of the month, I'm so sorry. Our word of the month is courage. Being brave enough to do what you should do, even when you're afraid. Can we say that together?
Courage.
Being brave enough to do what you should do, even when you're afraid.
And man, I'm so happy you're here. I was getting...
Wait, what's that? Sorry, I'll be right back.
No, don't go. This doesn't give me anxiety or anything. Anyways, I know a way to not be afraid. How about playing a really fun game? There's a map that leads to the Tree of Truth, and we'd be lost without it. But the only problem is, on my way up here, an eagle took the map out of my backpack and ripped it up into four different sections. Do you guys think you can help me find it? Okay, here's how you play. Where's my map? So, how you play is there's four different pieces hidden all around the room, and I'm gonna pick a group to help me go find them. Got it? Okay, let's go. So, do you guys want to help me find one? Okay, how about we can look, let's look over here, like under the mat, under the rugs. Oh, wow, you already found one, okay. Great job, guys. Okay, you guys can sit down. Can you guys help me find some? So let's look around these rugs. You're gonna have to lift them up. Oh, you found it. Great job. Okay, you can sit down. Oh, thank you. Okay. Are you guys all one group? Okay, you guys can help me. Let's look over here. Do you guys want to look? Oh, thank you. Let's see, one more. Do you guys want to help me?
Yeah.
Okay, so the last one, you guys can come. Over here, come on. The last one's located somewhere around here. Over there. Maybe under the chair, maybe. Oh. Thank you. Okay, you guys can go sit back down. Great job, everyone. You did an amazing job. Give yourself a big round of applause. Mom, what are you doing here?
Oh, hey, yeah. So have you seen our dogs? They escaped again. And you know, they're always doing that in the most inappropriate time, like when it's not convenient for me at all. We know how those naughty dogs are. Have you seen them?
No.
No, you haven't seen them? Okay, so cool. Wait a minute. What are you doing here? Why are you here all by yourself? And why are you here without your mother's present? I mean, seriously. Did you all just sneak off?
I guess. Wait, yes. I need that tape for
the
map.
I found it
in the jungle. It was just
they're just
so random.
Doing their own thing. Yeah, so there's tape. What is that?
The map.
The map?
You mean the one the eagle took out of your backpack?
Yes.
An eagle took it out of your backpack? Oh my goodness.
We have to tape it together.
I missed out on all the fun. All the time. Okay, so we're going to put it together. I love it. All right. Okay.
No, this
you guys
goes,
look like you know what you're doing, really?
This
okay.
goes over here.
Yeah.
No, stop.
Oh,
no.
Goodness.
No,
no, no, this side.
No.
This. Oh, look.
Oh,
I recognize this lake. Oh, let's see. What? Annalie, do you think, where does that go here?
There's some mountains right there.
Oh, mountains. I love it.
Here.
See if we can stick it together. Good thing you found that tape. All right,
maybe.
Okay. We got it. Eureka! I know exactly what this is the map of. This is the map of the Jungle of Jehovah. Oh, girls, get excited, because we are going to be able to find the Tree of Truth in no time. Oh, well, I'm so glad, because I didn't know the way, and the map is so important.
Wait.
Yeah, it's done.
There's something
it's
on
good.
The back.
Oh, well, looks like another language, but I can't tell which one it is.
Well, good thing I got my trusty, dusty little magnifying glass here. I know, shock, right? Your mother's always prepared. Let me see if I can make it out. Oh, fun little fact, everybody. You girls might not know this, but your mother knows 43 different languages. That's right. English is my favorite. But let me see here. Yes, this is Swahilian. Oh, also fun fact about your mother. Learned that in third grade. So I'm going to have to dig back in the brain quite some. Ooh, this says Joshua 1:9 right here. Joshua 1:9. And it says this. It says, be strong and brave. Do not be afraid. Do not lose hope. I am the Lord your God, and I will be with you everywhere you go.
That seems important.
You are not wrong. It is important. And you want to know why it's so important? It's because it's our verse of the week and the month here in the park. Yeah, Joshua 1:9. I know, Annalie's excited. I think we should say it together. What do you think? Yeah, let's do it. One, two, three.
Be strong and brave. Do not be afraid. Do not lose hope. I am the Lord your God, and I will be with you everywhere you go. Joshua 1:9.
Great job. Wow. They sound like they got a lot of courage.
Yeah.
Believe in that. That's awesome.
Hey, do you think we should go set up camp somewhere?
Sure.
Let's go.
Okay. Go be careful. Stay together. And I may need your help later. Okay. Well, that's fun. It's fun to get to be together. Is everybody excited to be here today? Yeah. Awesome. Well, I'm excited that you're here. And I love that we get to focus on courage here in the park. Now, who's got courage? Who do you think you have courage? I love it. And do you know where we get our courage from? God, that's right. And he tells us that he is strong and courageous, and he is brave, and he is mighty, right? And he calls us not to lose hope because he is our Heavenly Father. And he tells us he's always with us. And that's why I love to worship him so much. And I know you all love to worship him as well. And so one way that we worship God here in the park is the... You know it. Great job. All right, I need 2 volunteers. So Super Gabby, you want to help me pick somebody? Oh, right here. Can he? You want to collect the offering? So you just take it around. Raise your hand high. Do you want to collect the offering? All right, so if you have an offering this morning, raise your hand high. You're going to walk around. Can you walk around? See our friends over here with their hands held high? Right here, if you have an offering, come walk over this way. Oh, we're going to take the long road. I love it. Here we go. Careful. And she can put her offering in there. You can put it in here. Good job. Say thank you. Awesome. All right. We have any friends back here? You have the offering? Oh, invisible money. That's a challenge because I can't see it. All right. We have an offering over here. Awesome. Do you have an offering? Right here. We were so close. Thank you. All right. Awesome. Okay. So if you can bring, Nora, you can bring those up here. She's donating her picture. I love it. You can set it right here. Good job. Do we have one more. All right. Isaac, can you go on over and grab his offering? Come on, friend. Isaac, do you see him over there? Keep on moving. There we go. Yes. Awesome. Isaac, right here. He's coming to you. Thanks, bud. All right. Bring it on up. Right here. Awesome job. Let's give a round of applause to our helpers. They did great. Yeah. Super Gabby's ready to dance, but we need helpers. It's time to keep praising God. All right. Let's see. You picking right here? Come on down. All right. Let's see. Is that like half or full? Full? All right. Come on down. Yep. Come on up. Awesome. We did it. I'm ready to worship God.
Star what?
This is Star. Is it Starlet? Everybody say hi, Starlet. Is it your first time on stage? Yes. All right. Let's give her a round of applause. That's so exciting. All right. We've got Reese out here. We know Reese. And who we got here? What's your name?
Victor.
All right. Is your first time on stage?
Mila.
No, you're professional. Awesome. And then who's our friend here?
Mila.
Say hi, Mila. Awesome. Is it your first time? Super Gabby. And this is Super Gabby. Is it your first time on stage? We got another one. Yes. Awesome. And she loves Wonder Woman. I know I'm ready to worship. Are you ready? Let's do it. 1, 2, 3. Hit it, Bruce. Oh, this is a fun one. Put those hands together. Come on. It's a new one. You do what I do. Here we go. Hup. Yes. I love it. I know y'all can walk. Walk it out here. Walk it out. Punch it back. Other side. Hit it.
There'll be some stuff
punch
that
it back.
I won't understand.
To the front. Come on.
I'm gonna
punch it.
Every now and again.
To the front again. Good job. Punch it. To the side. Let's go.
I know you're holding
punch it
else could.
Good, again.
I know you're working
every day. All right, let's take it low. Take it low. Reach it up high. Good.
Every heartache.
Good.
Every let down, you're raising it up for my good.
Every season. This is Romans 8:28. God's working all things together. Top of course.
I believe.
Walk it out.
Sometimes my
best back right here.
The best of me.
To the front, let's go.
These days I struggle
Lunch
to
back.
Trust like I should. Still
Do
I know your work.
Lunch it.
Everything for my
down.
God. Every trial.
Down.
Every hope.
Down. Good.
Every let down.
Come
you're
on,
raising
come on.
It
let's
up
see it.
For
let's
my
go down.
Good. Every season.
Good.
Every new day.
Nice.
Every moment you're making.
Swing and pull. Top of the board. Good job.
Every moment you're
nice.
Making away
keep it
from
going.
My
good, good. Nice.
Oh,
all right. Now we ask, why should I worry?
Would I worry?
And then reach really big stretch. He's the great I am.
I may not know.
I don't know what tomorrow
what
brings,
tomorrow holds.
But he holds tomorrow.
Holds tomorrow.
Amen. Punch it low. I don't worry.
Lord, you are the great
God is the great I am. Punch it up.
Up. Oh,
good. Yes.
But I know.
Amen. Touchdown squat. Down. Up. Come on. Fourth and fifth grade boys. Come on. Woo. Every season. Good. Nice. Nice. I like it. Keep it going. Down. Job, you guys have a seat. You rocked it. I love it. Now, what's really cool is it's November, and we had a new awesome song that we just did, but you know I like to bring back some oldies. So we're going to get back up on our feet, and we're going to worship God again. All right, I need two helpers. Got to pick another one. Do you want to come on down? Come on down. Super Gabby's picking friends. All right, come on down. I saw you rocking it out. All right, let's go. All right, yep. All right, we got our friends in the house. All right, I love getting all these beautiful little faces up here on stage to worship God. So you guys can hop up on the second level here. Be careful. Thank you. All right, what's your name?
Elena.
Elena, say hi, Elena.
Hi, Elena.
Very nice. Is it your first time on stage? Yes! Yes! Are you excited?
Yes. Isabel.
Yes. And Super Gabby's got Isabel. Say hi, Isabel.
Hi, Isabel.
Good job.
Hi,
and is it Isabel's first time on stage?
No.
No. Professional. Love it. And what's his name, Super Gabby?
Josiah.
Say hi, Josiah.
Hi, Josiah.
Good. And Josiah, is it your first time on stage?
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Awesome. I know we're excited. That's fun. And then who's this?
Isaac.
Isaac. Say hi, Isaac. Awesome. Is it your first time on stage?
Yes.
Oh, I love it. I love it. And we not last, but and certainly not least. Here, what's your name?
Naaman.
Hi. Say hi, Naaman.
Hi,
Naaman. Nice. Is it, oh, did you say? Yeah, you guys had it right, right? Did I say it right? Good. And then what? Is it your first time on stage?
No.
Okay. Whew. All right. Professional in the house. Okay. I know we're ready.
What's your favorite dinosaur?
Oh, we're going rogue. Okay. I love it. What? Do you have a favorite dinosaur? Super Gabby's just dying to know. We're in the jungle. Do you think we're going to see any T-Rex this year? Oh, I hope not. All right. Let's put our mics up and we are ready to go. The question is, we're on song number 2. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not, no, they're not ready. Are you ready? Yes! Let's drum it up. Here we go. Hit it up.
I was down on my luck, I was stuck, I was running my broken heart.
Yes, up.
I was sinking so fast, I couldn't last, falling apart.
Squeeze up,
guys. You could have run away.
Good.
Leaving me there in my shame. Leaving me fighting my pain. But you made
roll
it that
back
way.
Oh. Punch it down. Good to get to worship with friends and get to worship with family. We love being together here in the park, and it really, truly brings my heart so much joy seeing all of you praise our Heavenly Father. He certainly deserves it, and He certainly loves all of you so, so much. So you all know what time it is. It's time to take that deep breath in and exhale. One more for good measure. We did two songs. Inhale and exhale. There we go. So we're going to be preparing our hearts for our Bible story today, which is awesome. God's word is so good. And we are going to be checking some pretty cool, interesting things out. Here we go.
What does fear feel like to you? Maybe it's butterflies fluttering in your stomach, or it might seem like cold fingers creeping up your spine. Fear can feel like a lump in your throat that makes it hard to swallow. Or it might chase thoughts round and round inside your head, refusing to stop. Enough! When you face something hard, fear can show up in 100 different ways. It can threaten to stop you in your tracks. But you don't have to let fear be the boss of you. When fear shouts, "You can't do it," stop. Take a deep breath. Listen for that still, quiet voice of God. God says, be strong and brave. Do not be afraid. Do not lose hope. I am the Lord your God. I will be with you everywhere you go. When you know that God is with you, you can keep going. You can walk straight through those fears. And when others see you choose to be brave, even when you're afraid, they can see God at work in your life. That's why courage is an amazing way to worship God with your life. Because worship is about more than just singing loud, it's all about living loud.
Hey everyone, how are you all doing today? Good. Shh. I have a very important story to tell you, and it might have a thing or two to do with spies. Because why would I be walking around like that and talking like that if it didn't have something to do with today's story, right? Like, that would make no sense. It would be as random as, I don't know, something along the lines of a random lightsaber battle.
This is my story now.
Annalie, I do have to put it out there that I kind of have to finish the story.
Oh.
Unfortunately, I don't think there were lightsabers in the Bible, so yeah, sorry. But anyway, all month long, we're talking about a new virtue. And that virtue is, does anyone remember it from earlier? What our virtue is? Courage, that's right, courage. Which is being brave enough to do what you should do, even when you're afraid. And in the past few months, we've been talking about the story of God's people, the Israelites, as we're going through God's big story, the Bible. And where we last left off, we had just finished up with the Egyptians, right? So we had Moses, who God sent to let his people go so that way they could be saved from slavery in Egypt. So Moses went and he talked to Pharaoh and he said, let my people go. And Pharaoh said, no. Yeah. Well, then God sent 10 plagues to convince Pharaoh to let his people go. And it did. It convinced Pharaoh. So the Israelites left Egypt and they were freed from slavery. Except Pharaoh kind of changed his mind. He was like, well, there went all of our free labor, so let's go chase after them. And that's what he did. Pharaoh got a bunch of his men, and he started chasing after the Israelites. But God saved his people, the Israelites, by parting the Red Sea so that they could walk through on dry land. And not only that, God continued to lead them on their way to the Promised Land. And they finally reached it. Except the thing is that obviously, if they reached the Promised Land, then everything should be all right, right? Like, this would be the easy part. They made it away from Pharaoh, they made it through the plagues, they made it through all of this, and now they had to go into the Promised Land. Except they had to go scout out the Promised Land because there just so happened to already be people living there.
Get out of here! This is our land!
Yeah, which he said, get out!
Well, now the Israelite people had to do something because God promised them this land. But there were already people there. So Moses got together 12 spies to go and check out Canaan, the Promised Land, so that they could figure out what they needed to do to make Canaan their home. Well, I think I'm distinctly lacking 12 spies, so I'm gonna need some volunteers to help me out. See, I'm gonna need some people to help me out here. So how about, let's see. See, do you wanna help me out?
What up?
I feel like you'd probably be good for it. Go ahead, come on up. Yeah, you both can. All right, so we're up to three. And then we have, how about you? Makes four. And yeah, go ahead, come on up. Makes five. You did? Well, you need to get some practice, right? Come on up. All right, so there we go. So how about, go ahead, come on up. And you, come on up. Let's see, how many are we at now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're up to 7. So how about you? And how about you? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm at 10. And then how about you? And that's 12, right? That makes perfect sense. I got 12 spies, didn't I? Let's see. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. What am I going to? Reese, there you are. Perfect timing, because you know what? You get to be our 12th spy. So here's a mask for you. And for all of our spies here, you all get masks as well. So here you are, and here you are, and you, and you, and you, and you. Where is it at? But you're a spy. You got to be able to blend in, right? And the best way to do that is to wear a mask, right? Something about that. Yeah, that's how that works. I was about to say, I feel like I've seen a spy movie or two like this. Here you are, and here you are. All right, well, we've got our 12 spies here, but I need to make sure that you're up for the job. So, I need my 12 spies. We're gonna do some spy practice. Ready? So first thing, we're gonna go sneak around. So, ready? Let me see you all tiptoe. Can you all tiptoe? Yeah. But remember, you gotta stay quiet. So everyone go, shh. All right. And then, now we're just gonna go sneak around the room. Ready? Gotta stay real quiet. Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Sneaking right around. They're never gonna spot us. Yeah. All right. There we go. Wait, but we gotta stay quiet. We can't let them know that we're here. All right. Ready? All right. There we go. You know what? I think y'all will be up for the task for being spies for this. But any good spy needs to have their assignment, right? Because you can't do a job as a spy if you don't have a job. So Moses gave his 12 spies some instructions.
Okay. Hello, Moses.
Hi, Moses.
Here are Moses. What were your instructions for your spies?
Let my people go.
Moses, I hate to stop you here, but that may have been a whole book of the Bible ago. We've moved ahead.
Well, you didn't let me finish.
Oh, okay. You're getting to it. Got it.
Let my people go to the promised land.
Oh, that makes perfect sense now. Perfect sense. Well, in the Bible, it says that Moses gave the spies these instructions.
See what the land is like. See whether the people who live there are strong or weak. See whether they are few or many. What kind of land do they live in? Is it good or bad? What kind of towns do they live in? Do the towns have high walls around them or not? How is the soil? Is it rich land or poor land? Are there trees in it or not? Do your best to bring back some fruit of the land.
All right.
Fruit.
All right. Well, with that, it was time for the spies to set off into Canaan. All right. So, we have our... Oh, no. I dropped the bucket.
Guys, come on.
There we go.
Go.
All right. Well, it's time for the spies to head off.
Look, there's cities. There's land. There's gardens. There's towns, berries, fruit, children, people, bushes, yes. Wait.
Wait, wasn't there something that Moses wanted y'all to bring back from the Promised Land?
Didn't Moses want us to bring back fruit? Look! At those big grapes over there! Oh.
All right.
Hey, let's go. Let's go back. Back to the stage.
So, finally, after 40 days, the spies came back to the camp of the Israelites just outside of Canaan. And they gave their report to Moses. Hey, Moses. The spies have a report for you.
Back so soon?
But they did. They found grapes. But I do have to say they have good news and bad news.
They're very mean.
Which would you like first?
The good news, of course.
All right.
Well, there were many gardens and tons of fruit, like grapes.
Oh, here. Let's go ahead and give the grapes to Moses here so we can check them out. Awesome.
Those are some pretty big grapes.
And the then, bad news? What about the bad news?
The people were powerful and the lands were big and scary.
I don't like the way that one looks at me. Off with this head!
Bro, chill, they're just in elementary school.
Fair enough, but I'm keeping my eye on you.
That is pretty scary. Oh, that was pretty scary. I should probably take these grapes and plan out our next move.
Makes sense, Moses. Thank you so much. Well, 10 of the spies all said, the land is way too scary and the people are too big. There's no way we could take the land of Canaan. No way is this the promised land.
Of course we can take Canaan.
But 2 spies said differently. 2 of them said that with God's help, that the Israelites would be able to make Canaan, the promised land, their home.
Let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
So, I'm going to need 2 spies to play Joshua and Caleb. So how about you? And how about you? All right. No, not this time around. Well, we have our Joshua and we have our Caleb, but our 10 spies, I want to thank you so much for helping out. So let's give them a huge round of applause, but I will need your masks back.
Here.
All right, so can I get the mask? Yep. Here we go. Yeah, if you want to help me collect them, thank you. Thank you. All right, so.
Thank you.
So, I need Joshua and Caleb to stay up here. So that's you two right here.
Excuse me?
Well,
yeah.
Do you think it was hard for Joshua and Caleb here to say something completely different than what 10 other spies who saw the same things? Do you think it was hard for them to be able to say that? Yeah, it probably was. But they had courage. They did what was the right thing even when nobody else was. And so the Israelites started to believe, the rest of the Israelites started to believe those 10 spies who said, there's nothing we can do. The promised land is not for us. And we should just turn around and go home to Egypt. Well, instead, they decided that Joshua and Caleb here, who were telling the truth and saying that they should believe in God and that he would take care of it, they decided that they needed to, well, get rid of them. Yeah. Well, when that happened, the glory of the Lord appeared. But, exactly. Well, and so the Lord appeared to Moses.
Lord, it is I,
Moses. Please forgive these people, for they have chosen to not trust you.
Well, God said that he would forgive the Israelites, but the 10 men who were spreading this bad report, well, they were struck down and killed. Yeah. And not only that, anyone who didn't believe that God would take care of his people, well, they were told that they would not be allowed to go into the promised land when they finally came back. And I say finally came back because everyone, all of the Israelites, also had to go and wander in the desert for another 40 years. Yeah. But for Joshua and Caleb, they were told that they would get to see the promised land and they would get to go in there. And fun fact, Joshua ended up leading the Israelites after Moses, which is really, really cool. So let's give a hand to our two spies right here. Thank you so much. Here we go. I can take the mask. And you all can head back to your seats. Thank you so much. Well, this is a really cool story about courage, right? I mean, you've got spies and you've got all of these really awesome things that happened. And at the heart of it, you have two people choosing to do what they should do even when it's difficult because they had courage throughout all of it. They trusted God and God gave them the courage to do the right thing. And not only that, we have the ability to do that. And that brings us to our bottom line for today, which is you can do what you should even when others are afraid. No matter what's going on, no matter how fearful everyone else is about the situation, and even if they're not doing the right thing or doing what they should because they're afraid, we have the ability to do the right thing no matter what. Because God gives us what?
Courage.
Exactly. So, let's go ahead and let's pray and ask God to help us to remember to always show courage, even when others might be afraid and won't. So, let's pray. Hey God, thank you for everything you've given us, for sending Jesus to die for us, that we could have a relationship with you forever. And thank you for being in our lives always, and for being with us no matter what happens. And for helping us to have courage through any situation, because you are with us. I ask now that as we go into this next week, that you continue to be with us and continue to remind us that you are with us and that you continue to help us to show courage and do the right thing, even when others are afraid. We pray all of this in Jesus' name and we thank you. Amen.